Welcome to a quick sharp review of Tatsuki Fujimoto Before Chainsaw Man short story collections. I'm going to be talking a bit about the physical release. I'm going to be talking about the books themselves, and lastly, what music I'd recommend listening to while reading them. So these are two books of short stories that were released. They're one shots that Tatsuki Fujimoto, who's known for Chainsaw Man and Fire Punch, did when he was between 17 and 21, and 22 and 26. I think it's around sort of the end of this time where he's making Fire Punch and Chainsaw Man, and then going on to make Look Back and Goodbye Eri, which are also quite popular now, and have physical releases. So we've got two books. Both of them have four short stories in them each, all not connected to each other. You'll see that this one's a little bit lighter on pages than this one. And we've got there's the covers of both of them. I like the sort of shared aesthetic going on here. There's the spines, sort of how they look on your shelf, and then there's the two back covers. So these are just a series of one shots that he made that were then published around those times. And you can see over time how his style evolves and what sort of stories he really likes doing. The common themes in these are obviously like supernatural stuff. So there's stories about aliens, demons, and there's these interesting monster designs that would become prevalent in Chainsaw Man. There's also, this sort of stuff is, these facial expressions are quite common in Chainsaw Man as well. So it's like that sort of cool mix of comedy and sci-fi, some action and drama and surprising emotional beats that you would see in his works. There's a lot of common themes about connecting with people under extreme circumstances. And you can see the art starting to evolve as well throughout these collections. The stories are pretty light themselves. Most of them are just, it's like a central sort of gag and he rolls with it. Some of them are sort of a bit more meaningful. I don't think any of these, after reading them for the first time, really stuck in my mind as truly great stories to like remember forever. Look at this amazing spread. Like, the artwork is really starting to get nice here. Like, 22 years old. Insane, the talent of some of these people. I think they're definitely worth a read, especially if you're a fan of his other works. Then you'll find something to like here. They're just quirky, weird stories, about like connecting to people, I think is sort of the main common thread. I'm just laughing remembering this story. It's pretty funny. And then lastly, what music I'd recommend listening to. I listened to the Persona 5 soundtrack. I think it has that same vibe of sort of off-kilter, weird stuff with a bit of action and comedy and, just like, it's hard because they're all sort of different stories, but they do have that same sort of Fujimoto feel of this is kind of serious, but also not really. But then having these surprising emotional beats. This last story, you can see a lot of inspiration coming through for Look Back, his other work, particularly this character thinking that she's like an amazing artist. Anyway, I'd recommend these. If you know of any other music you'd recommend listening to while reading these, let me know. See you next time. Thanks. Bye.